I always knew that one day I will make my own movies, will tell my own stories. So in a way, acting was a kind of detour to movie making. Quite long detour, because I've been an actor since I was 18. I always invented stories, but they never, I felt them never, you know, good enough to really get out with. And with this story, it was for the first time that it stayed in my mind and really wanted to be told. The story forced me, write me, please, to an end and show it to somebody. Before I shot this movie, before I had research for the movie, I never saw a dead body before in my life. When I started writing the script, I got to a certain point where I knew I have to do more research. I cannot write on by never knowing what are my feelings seeing a dead body. And so I went to the city mortuary of Vienna and introduced myself, told them about the project, and they took me with them at the morning to the hospitals, and there I saw my first dead bodies. And this was really one of the most important experiences I ever had in my life before, and this gave me the courage to show and to tell the story like this, because I felt for the first time that it's a story about life and death, and telling the story of a young guy who has no sense for life and gets a sense for life through death. Shooting was not that complicated. We shot it originally in the Morgues. Is it Morgues? And of course, we had no real dead bodies. There were extras and made up and digitally. afterwards, we had to stop their breathing and their pulse, of course. For me, it was very important to tell this story, especially because death is something we don't want to look at, and death is it's the end of our lives. And so it was for me very clear that if I really want to show a movie about a person who tries to find a way into life, he stays a little bit beside life, I need a strong, you know, a counterpoint. I don't know the expression, and the strongest is death. So I made this story up, working with dead people, and getting a sense for a very simple idea that I only can act, I only can do something as long as I breathe, and afterwards it's over. It's great. It's really great being with your first movie, an invitation to a film festival, being in the competition. It's the best thing you can happen to you. Because you get an idea of you. It's such a long time you work on the movie, shooting it, editing, the post-production. You s- s- something of there's the danger that you lose why you really actually made it for getting out into life, for an audience, for other human beings watching it, making up their minds, talking about it. And you get it back now, in this case, and this is really great, because all the work and all the struggling and all the doubts you have while working get now a reason why you had it.
Well, it was kind of a funny story, because it was on a Saturday, and I hadn't. I didn't do anything, so I asked a friend of mine if we do something together, and he said, "No, I can't. I go to that casting, you know." And I told him, "Yeah, well, I'll come with you, and after that we'll do something." And he said, "All right." And at the casting, I was of course very nervous, and I always had the feeling there were a lot of professional actors. You know, I just thought, "What am I doing here?" You know. And then I went in and did my part naturally, and I got a call that I'm in the second casting, and then I met Carl, and we did a scene together. It was mad, just crazy. And yeah, then he told me I'm the one. I did a lot of preparation with Carl, so he would talk to me a lot before every scene, talk what he's expecting, what he thinks of that scene. And I also did the castings with the other actors. I was the first one to be chosen. And it was always important to be close to Carl, you know. And after a while, I knew what was in his head. I knew what he's expecting, and I kind of grow in that role. Thinking of that, I'd just been to Vienna, and I just finished a school year, and I'm on holidays now. And now I'm in Sarajevo on the red carpet. That's mad. It's still a bit unreal, you know. And people can't really believe it. It's I can't really tell what I'm doing here. And it's, yeah, unreal.